And now we are actually recording. Awesome.
Hey, good. Hey. Welcome to Fran Bow.
Welcome to Fran Bow, guys. A heartwarming tale about a girl and her little cat, Mr. Midnight.
And other fun things.
This will be fun to edit.
Let the love begin.
Everything's fine. It feels like heaven. I see my parents. They look happy. See? Heartwarming.
Mm-hmm.
They have a present for me.
The heartwarming basket.
I wonder. It's a kitty! It's so sweet and pretty. It's dark as the deepest night.
Batman, please.
Catman? It's Mr. Midnight. It's my best friend. My only friend.
Oh, no.
Oh, we're having dinner, and I see Aunt Grace, too.
Why was that a question?
I don't know. I really like her a lot, I guess. Oh, kitty, it's Friday. My parents are going out. I thought they were going to drive into that tree for a second. Aunt Grace takes good care of me. Kitty's so cute with his milk. Oh, my God. We're having so much fun. Is that spaghetti? Oh, the cat. I want that cat. It's Monday night. Something, something, something. But something feels real bad. Oh. He's got a weird nose. It's a strange creature outside my window.
A really big window.
I don't like it. It scares me.
Like three times that child size.
Suddenly, I hear something. It's Mom, screaming. I want to know what's wrong. A bright light shines from my parents' room. I go closer. And closer. Bloody knife. Mom? Dad? Please, don't. Mommy? Daddy? He's hugging her. He's so cute. He's glaring at something.
Garky, oh, scaredy cat.
Hey, people. It's a cult leader. He's picking us up.
Taking us for the ride of our lives.
Fran, please, follow my voice. On the count of three, you will wake up. One. Two. Three. Fran, how do you feel?
I feel like dying. I don't know about you.
I feel like dying. I don't understand why you make me do this. Try to calm down. This is part of your recovery. My parents are dead, brah.
Bruh.
Bruh. Recovery. Don't you get it? My parents are dead. Oh, poor thing. Everything will get better. I promise. Then you should just let me go now, because that totally makes sense. That would be better if you let me go. You should not tell me how to do my job. But now, I have something for you, Fran.
Really?
See the desk? There's a little package for you. It's from Aunt Grace. Take it.
Grace?
Aunt Grace. I'm Sean Connery, don't you remember?
Yes. How could I forget? I've been trying to forget.
From the time that we've been playing this game that we never actually played it. don't know what you're talking about. It's not something that happened in the past.
Never.
Fran, stop it. Take your aunt's present now. It was from my aunt and not from my mother. That's right. Well, it was my mother's purse, though.
Guess your aunt's a thief.
Thiefery. Open it. There's something inside. I don't want it. Dearest Fran, here's the purse you like so much. I thought you would like to have it. When I was thinking about you, I remembered that you like to examine objects and combine them with other things. So, I hope you'll always keep this purse and give it and all the other things you find a good use. Use. Haha. Never forget that creativity is absolutely the greatest gift that you have. Love, Aunt Grace.
I mean, I like how they did the whole, like, combine, examine, use, but then you can't just... You can't switch the noun to verb thing, you just...
It doesn't work.
It doesn't, it
I
makes
agree
me
with
so
you.
Upset.
She's right. Worried about you, though, anyways.
Aunt Grace.
Well, just another reason to let me go. Well, don't worry about her. She's fine. I am tired of all of this. I just want to go home.
Well, you kind of can't.
Yes, you can leave. But before you do, it is time for your new medicine.
Don't contradict me, Dr. Connery.
Too bad. I don't want to try more medicine, even though that's not the right voice. It's called duotine, and it will make you feel very relaxed. Nurse, we're ready. You are the nurse.
I'm realizing I'm... shut up. I realized that, and I was going to start talking, but then you interrupted me by saying things I already understood. Uh-huh. Anything new today, Dr. Dern?
Dr. Dern? Nothing, actually. Same visions as before.
Oh, I see.
Apparently we've had multiple visions in the past. Lovely.
Here, Fran, take your medicine.
What if I don't wanna? What if I... Can I... We don't have all day, Fran. Take the pills now. You are fucking pushy, mister. Mm-hmm. I don't want any of your shit.
I want to just stare at the pig fish thing that apparently isn't a pig fish.
Big fish. It's an eye and an ear and a mouth. And I totally... Oh, God. What?
Good.
Lovely. Oh, no. Take her back to her room. A nurse. Don't let her take this ever again. I think my Sean Connery accent is pretty on point. It probably isn't, but that's besides the point.
Close enough.
Beware, Fran Bow. If you leave the House of Madness, I will hunt you down, catch you, and bring you back to insanity. Fran, wake up. The medicine will help you escape. I'll be waiting for you in the forest. I love you.
He's my favorite.
I love Mr. Midnight, even though I'm pretty sure he is just a representation of our insanity. Chapter 1, My Sober Day.
He may be crazy cat, but he's my cat. kind of crazy cat.
Sanity is overrated anyway.
Yeah.
Anyways, we're going to have a sober day. It's going to be so sober. It's going to be
it's
like...
It's a sober day, and it's mine.
I'm still here. Hideous place. I have to get out of here. Yeah, we probably should. There's a clown picture. I'll get your nose. I'ma get it. Are you a happy clown? Can you make me laugh? I'm having a hard time laughing again.
That got sad real quick.
That escalated quickly.
It did.
Case something that I'm not gonna even bother trying to read. Name, Fran Bow Dagenhart.
Wait, is it Fran or Fran?
I don't really care. I will pronounce it probably both ways over the course of this Let's Play, and it doesn't really matter that much to me.
Okay.
I do like that last name, though, Dagenhart. That is pretty,
it is cool.
It kind of reminds me of Dragonheart, and I loved that movie as a kid. So, you are now Fran Bow Dragonheart. Age, 10. Gender, female. History. I don't know why I'm waving around the hand like this. The patient was found near the Oswald Asylum, showing signs of psychosis. The Bow Dragonheart family tragedy. Details omitted. They were eaten by a dragon, though. You should probably know that. Treatment. Dr. Marcel Dern has tried different medications, and all have been cancelled because of side effects.
Gosh darn it. Darn.
I love that last name. Documented July 25th, 1944. We are in the past.
I'm pretty sure it's supposed to be Dern, but I don't care. It's Dern.
Hopefully this won't fall on my head while I'm sleeping.
No.
This cross. Because that would be bad. That would be painful.
A little bit.
Red and Tiny, you are hiding from me. Oh, it's Mr. Midnight, but he's like about the same size as we are. And then there's a bunch of pills. It's like confetti. Holy crap. I hate this monster.
The monster.
Shush. That's besides the point. He hasn't done anything anyway. He's certain to bring us back to insanity. But other than that, he's a pretty cool guy.
Yeah. I invite him for tea one day.
Tea party? Why are we screaming?
I have what?
Like, right here in the picture, we're screaming, like, ah! I have to find Mr. Midnight! I have to find him now! Because there's two exclamation marks. I miss my kitty.
Kitty!
He hides because he's afraid. He told me that the medicine would something show me where he is. Heart, heart, heart. I can still walk around it and see what's on the other side. Yeah, that is a good point. Let's try to go back to bed. I don't wanna. I just woke up.
Yeah. Duh.
Like, dur.
What's the use of you?
Music box? Oh, sweet, sweet melody. One more time. La la la. Does the same as before. Huh.
Now you pissed her off, man.
I mean, yeah, she doesn't look too happy about that.
It's so stern.
She's just like, I'm fed up with your shit. It's locked. It's a good reason to get curious. I should get the key for this. I probably should. Oh. Holy moly! Something fell.
That's adorable.
A handy hook. I will play a pirate with it later. Because I can hide it in my sleeve, even though my sleeves are really, really high on my shirt. I guess I broke the curtains, but now I can look outside. So, you know, look on the bright side of life.
It's nighttime, there's no bright side.
That's pretty bright, and that's pretty bright, and that's sort of kind of bright, I guess.
Go away.
Tower defense! We have for you a crazy person named Fran. Or is it a defense tower? I guess this is my way out. But I don't think my head would fit through the window.
Just try really hard like a cat. If you were Mr. Midnight, you could.
That is very true. Cats can fit through lots of tiny little areas. They're like a liquid, you know? But my legs are just fine anyways. I'm not disabled, so there's no reason. Aside from, you know, racing people in the hallways, because that would be pretty fun, even if you're not disabled.
Getting an arm workout.
It's not very easy to see through these planks. you know. Is that the playground? Maybe somebody already tried jumping through this window.
Can I just point out that her dress looks like it has a small bow tie on it? And her name is Fran Bow.
It kind of also looks like a jellyfish, or like a little green skull that's deformed. Empty bottle, empty glasses, nothing useful.
Empty chairs and empty tables where my friends will sing no more. Or eat no more. Or sit no more. I don't remember the words.
I can't see through this window. It doesn't work. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's the same view as the window next to it. I suppose, but you can kind of see through the little corner here.
Don't patronize her.
I'm just saying.
Don't.
Also, how could somebody try to jump out the other window if you can't even fit through these bars anyways? Unless she's got like an abnormally large head. Like, maybe all the rest of the kids in the hospital just have tinier heads and they can actually fit through these. That's kind of sad. The playground. Good night, trees and moon. I'm pretty sure the playground isn't a good escape route. It's the best escape route. You can ride that little kangaroo to freedom.
Yeah.
It's totally a kangaroo. The bunny swing thingy. No, it's not a bunny. It's a kangaroo. You obviously didn't hear me right the first time, Fran.
Maybe? Oh, sorry.
I want to know what she's writing. I'm curious. Sorry, anyways, what were you saying?
Maybe the reason why she can't fit her head through or fit her body through is because she's 10. And, like, once you're 10, you're like, oh, you're double digits. You're old and, like, useless now. But, like, if you're 9, you're small enough to just kind of, like, get away with anything. You can get away from the hospital. And so if you're 9 years old, you can fit the little bars, but once you turn 10, you're like, nope, my head's gonna swell and I'm gonna be useless and stuck here forever.
I think you have a false idea of the way that puberty works.
I don't think I do, no.
I think I'm
right.
I guess the nurse would never let me touch anything, but I want to touch it. Oh, Fran, oh, you're awake.
Hey! Hey!
Oh, that's right. Hey. That's you.
Stop talking. Oh, Fran, you're awake. Good.
How long was I asleep for?
3 days, maybe.
That's a long fucking time, bro. So many days, I should find my kitteh.
Your cat is probably dead, girl. Now leave, I'm working.
You fucking bitch. Jesus.
That turned real fast.
That's really mean. My cat is not dead. My cat is immortal. Thank you very much.
Cat 9 lives.
Something happened. I forgot about it, though, until now.
See, you are nothing but trouble. What is it?
I kind of maybe sort of broke the curtains, but not really.
Accidentally. I have to fix this. Follow me.
It was Mr. Midnight, even though he's not here. I swear. It was not my fault. It was the other guy.
The other guy.
The other guy with the top hat. He made me do it. I can look out the window and completely ignore the lady. That's cool.
Good. Something is missing. Have you seen the hook that holds the curtains up?
What's the hook?
Well, I have to go and find something to fix this, you little girl.
I'm still confused as to what a hook constitutes.
Hook me up with the answer, bro.
I don't know why I stuttered that many times on constitutes, but that's besides the point.
That's alright.
Sweet, we have healing items. And apparently we don't like coffee or tea or whatever's in that cup.
He's fantastic.
Violent trauma can have a great impact on children, totally changing their normal lives. For example, children damaged by trauma can have mild to severe deficits in some abilities, such as trusting people near them, seeing the world as a safe place, and making decisions, etc. Because of these effects, some traumas can lead to several symptoms of major mental illness. For example, not trusting other people or not feeling safe in the world. This can be interpreted as paranoia. There's a nice little drawing of the brain. With frontal lobe, traumas, and trauma is a word that the doctor indeed loves to say. Hee hee, that brain looks like a turtle.
What?
I mean, kind of, I guess, if the turtle was in its shell.
Alright.
Fran, I love you. You're awesome.
Alright. Are you ready for this? Lettuce something.
Maybe.
Fran Bow Dragon Fruit.
Dragon Fruit?
Looks like, bro.
It does look like dragon fruit.
Just saying. The patient, I just want to point out that you had the super easy book thing to read and I have to read this chicken scratch. Anyway.
You're welcome.
The life I lead. The patient has been asleep for almost all the time.
He's been asleep?
Shut up. She only wakes up to drink water. But I don't think she... You're going over the words, okay? Stop that. Remembers that. After drinking, she goes to sleep again. She hasn't been social for 3 days. Stop it. I hate you so much. Social for 3 days now. Some kids have come around and asked about... Stop moving, you're distracting me. Asked about her and when
you're
she would
distracted.
Come out to play. H, you suck. The thing you have to understand is that I haven't slept in weeks.
Weeks, huh?
I get like, there are some days where I get like good 9 hours and some days where I get like 4 hours.
That's still sleeping though.
I mean, okay, sleep as in like proper sleep. I don't sleep well.
I think this is where the medicine is, but it's locked.
That's where the hope is.
I will try to open that at some point. Oh god, it's a gun. Holy crap, that's terrible. Why would the nurse have this? She wants to kill us all.
Oh, that makes sense.
I'll leave it as it was. I really need to get out of this place. Yeah, I mean... The Gers has a nun. Then, you know, shit is really going sideways at that point. That's generally a bad sign. Oh, a secret box. Shh.
You shush me.
Shh.
No.
It's America. A little box. It's open.
Ah.
I can open it. It's a key. Ooh, I wonder if that'll open the...
The thingy.
Yeah.
The thing. Yeah.
The thing and the stuff.
I was gonna say that, but I didn't want to spoil. Because I have foreknowledge, because we messed up.
Shut up. That never happened. I don't know what you're talking about. That was an alternate universe. I hope that somebody loves this little teddy bear. Yeah. Hello again, Mr. Teddy. You deserve all the love in the world.
I hope somebody loves you, because I sure don't.
Jeez. Back and forth, Mr. Wooden Horse. It's the trip of our lives. Yeehaw! I should be wearing a little cowboy hat.
You should.
If I sit down, I will eventually get up, so what's the point?
Alright.
I mean, I guess that's a sort of a valid point. To be seated or not to be seated, that is the question. I used to have a blue dress like yours.
I thought that said blood dress for a second, and I was like, oh no, that's not good.
A blood dress. I can't play with you now. I'm on a very secret mission. Case 12114553 6. Fillmore Bronston. Age 8. So he could probably fit through the window.
Yeah.
With your logic, at least. The patient came to Oswald Asylum with his mother, Rachel Bronston. The boy has developed paranoid behavior. Paranoia not yet diagnosed. Treatment. Daily treatment with Dr. Marcel Dern. We have not achieved the patient's trust, and he refuses to be questioned. April 6th of the same year as the other one.
Wait, why aren't we talking to him?
I mean, we could.
It might be helpful. Don't be rude.
Hey, Phil, how's it going?
Hello. Hello. How you doing, bro?
How are you today?
Everybody says that I'm sick.
I mean, I don't know if he's actually sick, though. Like, they're stupid peoples. They always say that. Are you leaving tonight? Oh, that was...
You're killing all my thunder. Are you leaving tonight? Don't patronize me. I can leave.
I will if you help me.
You can't, though. The only thing I know is that the office is the key.
There's a key inside?
I saw the doctor write a secret code.
A secret code, huh? To open the yellow door?
He doesn't want me to tell you.
Who doesn't?
Him.
What? Oh God, what? All doors are closed. You are a prisoner of my games. And nobody will help you escape. Leave me alone. I hate you.
Told you he was helpful.
Mommy. Daddy. I need you so much right now. No. I won't let that monster stop me. Well then, I was not expecting that.
No.
Right. I guess we should...
Dresser. The white dresser.
Oh, right. The key.
Yeah, la clé.
Right. It's a tiny little key. Let's do it. Yes, I got it. And there's something inside. What is this? It's a hair clip. I should give it a good use. Can we put it in our hair? Oh, hey, it's us and our family, and I'm guessing that's Aunt Grace.
Why are our eyes so terrifying compared to theirs?
We have huge eyes, Jesus.
Oh my gosh.
Especially compared to everybody else.
That's so
Why?
Scary.
It's my dear family. I'll guard this with my life. Oh, I miss you so much. I really need you here with me to keep my eyes from growing out of my head.
The beginning when she said that she sees her parents, like, she wasn't joking. She really sees everything, doesn't she?
Like, she just knows the secrets to the universe. Like, she can see on different dimensions, man.
See, his eyes are bulbous as well.
Maybe it's just because they're little kids. It's locked. I'm guessing I probably have to use this to maybe unlock it. Like, as a apoclic? That is not the right words at all. A lockpick. It fits, but there are two holes. I need something else.
His eyes are probably maybe even bigger than yours.
Oh, maybe I can combine the golden hook with it.
Yeah, you need generally two pieces of picking locks. One to push up the pins and one to turn.
But the shape is not right. That didn't work.
Oh.
Still locked. Thanks, Fran Bow. I appreciate that. I better keep these for later. Yeah, I don't know why I tried that in the first place.
Did you check his cross?
Oh, hide. Oh, maybe we can open this.
8.
I did try his cross, it didn't do anything.
No.
So H is 8, right?
Mm-hmm.
Open!
There was an E on the thing and a D.
Yeah, so that would be four.
Oh, and nine.
Okay, cool. That should work. Use 8.
9.
Yeah! Hey. It worked. The pills! Kitteh told me that these would help me. Oh! Okay. Watch your step. There's a dead rat on the floor.
That's always good.
You got a little blood on your mouth. Are you okay? My mommy also had blood on her mouth. She looked sad. Oh. What is this thing? Get out, creepy creature.
Well then.
What are you, huh? Tell me. You like to see me sad? Why is there a dead nurse in this wheelchair? Hello, Miss Nurse.
She's so calm about it, too.
She does not seem fazed by this at all. I feel like it's because... Okay, creepy noises in the background, that's cool. Okay, she seems a little fazed by this now. But I guess it's because she has a hard time differentiating reality from fiction.
Maybe. It also looks like because of the blood spatter on like behind her, it looks like she used the gun that was like in the table.
Yeah.
That was interesting.
Oh, hey, I just noticed there's eyes looking at us.
Oh.
And then there's this guy from before, and then this skeleton with a top hat.
Top hat!
That's awesome. I got a small and Sharpie pin. It might fit somewhere. Assuming that's what we have to use with this for the lockpick.
Yeah, probably.
That would probably be good. I like also how in this world with the pills, the middle window is not there anymore because we couldn't see out of it before.
Oh.
I'm assuming that's why it's not there anymore. Because that was the only window we couldn't see out from in this room.
Mm.
Oh. Dead rabbit. Oh god, what is that?
I don't like that.
I don't want to look at it. Oh, what the fuck?
I don't like this game.
Oh, is that my head?
So, like, perfunctory. So, like, matter of fact about it.
Give me my head back, please. She just doesn't give a shit. Just go away, you weird creatures. That guy looks kind of like a plague mask. And the other two look... That guy, actually, over here, looks like the puppet from Saw. It's Jigsaw. Oh, are you sleeping, sweet bunny?
What do you think, Fran?
Bunny, wake up. Mm-hmm. Please, bunny. Just wake up. It wasn't me. Or was not me, I guess. There's no contraction in that sentence. There's also a pair of steps? That is not the right word.
There's just two steps. They don't go anywhere.
There's just two steps, and then they just disappear. There's a flight of steps leading down where our bed used to be.
It's my two-step plan to go nowhere. Okay, I'm sorry, I'm done.
Who did it? Obviously the bunny did it.
Well then.
That's the same. Also, the clown has obviously escaped the painting.
This isn't Eve. Where did he go?
Where'd the clown go?
No, There's gonna be a creepy clown. I don't like clowns.
I hope he's not around here.
No, no, no.
It looks like he escaped from the painting.
No. I really don't like this. I don't like clowns.
On that note, I feel like this is a good part to stop for the first episode.
Yeah.
And then, we can continue on after this. But this seems like a good stopping point for the first one.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Have a good night, guys.
Bye.
Aisha, I have a portrait on my wall. He's a serial killer. I thought he wouldn't escape. Aisha, he got out.